ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमो मह्यम सुखं नित्यं स प्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेर्कृत निर्मलं अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहनोत्तम निधि मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो आफ्टर अन्यथा ख्याति All the khyatis and anyata khyatis that we saw yesterday as a summary, continuing in the fourth chapter. I think last we had seen 146. In the adhyasa sthala, anyata khyati says, sarasad vilakshanaha anirvachaniyaha. There is an anirvachaniya sarpa or anything that is adhyastha, that is anirvachaniya. Evameva shuktyadhyadhikarani shupi aropita rajatadayaha tatkalikataya anirvachaniya taya utpannaha. So they are utpannaha but anirvachaniya. Not sat, not asat, but visayas come up in an anirvachaniya way. And utpannaha santa pratibhanti. अस्य अनिर्वचनीयस्य सर्पादेः ख्याति प्रसिद्धि प्रतीतिः स्फुरणम् अभिवदनञ्च अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति इत्युच्यते. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति. दि नेम एंड फॉर्म, दि विषय एंड विषयक ज्ञान, बोथ आर अनिर्वचनीय. ब्रह्मस्थले सर्पज्ञानमपि अविद्या परिणामः सर्पतज्ञानयोर् युगपदेव उत्पत्तिलयौ सर्पः साक्षिभाष्यश्च. Did we see this 147 as well? I don't recall the last one.
Guruji, I think we need to start at 142.
Sorry?
I think we stopped at 141.
We finished all that.
Oh, sorry. 151.
151, okay. So, yeah. So, because I just went back yesterday and then the page is there, stuck there, sorry. So, 151.
You're done with 151 and start from 152.
So yeah, I forgot the number. So 151 also you finished. So Rajju, anyway, so Atra Akshepa Samadhan. Akshepa was a Rajju Jnana Sarpa Nivruttir Na Syad Iti Akshepa. There won't be Sarpa Nivrutti and Sarpa Jnana Nivrutti also. This will come up later. First, we saw, I think, Sarpa Nivruttir Na Syad and the Samadhana to that. Rajju Jnana Sarpa Nivruttir Na Syad. It is akshepa. Why? Because adhishthana is chaitanya, whereas you are saying rajju jnana will take away sarpa. Then sarpa jnana is also there. That is also going to go away by rajju jnana. Now that can't be right because adhishthana is not rajju. The siddhanta is adhishthana jnana adhyasa nivrutti. If that is the case, the purva pakshi asks, how can rajju jnana take away adhyasa? Because adhishthana is not rajju, it is chaitanya. So chaitanya jnana should take away sarpa. And then Sarpajnana also, but Sarpajnana has a different objection as well. We'll look at that. Now Rajjujnana was explained, we saw yesterday also, Rajjujnana itself is Chaitanya. Jnana is Chaitanya, therefore Rajjujnana is what the Chaitanya is revealed. Chaitanya is revealed, which is Rajju Avachinna. Rajjujnanena Rajju Avachinna Chaitanyam Nyayate. That's the, Nyayate means that itself is, Chaitanya itself is revealed. Prakashate, Prakashate ityartha. Therefore, Rajyujnana Sarpa Nivritti Bhavati Eva. That was the Samadhana there. Rajyujnana Sarpadhyadishthana Jnanam Bhavati Iti Samadhi. And then, what happens? Rajyujnana does a Avarana Bhanga. So, Bhagna Avaranam Sat Sarpadhyadishthana Rajyujnana Chaitanyam Swayameva Prakashate. Shines up on its own, which is this Chaitanya, which is Rajyu Avachinna Chaitanya. So, Rajju Jnanena Rajju Avachinna Chaitanyam Swayameva Prakashate Tataha Rajju Jnanameva Sarpadhyadishthana Jnana Rupam Api Bhavati. Thereby, Adishthana being known, there is Rajju Jnanena Tatascha Rajju Jnana Sarpadhi Nivrutti Ryujyate Eva. Thereby, the Sarpa Nivrutti, Sarpa Vishaya will go away by Rajju Jnana because Rajju Jnana is Chaitanya, Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya. Jnana reveals that thereby the adhisthana jnanena sarpadi adhyasta nivrutti arupita nivrutti. Prajnana Sarpajnanam na nivartyate iti akshepa. Okay, he says, let the Sarpa go. But what about the Sarpajnana? Sarpajnana does not have Rajya Vachinna Chaitanya as Adhishthana. So Rajyujnanena yat Rajyu. Rajyujnanena yat Rajyochinna Chaitanyam Prakashate Tattu Sarpajnanasya Adhishthanam na bhavati. That is not the Adhishthana of Sarpajnana. For Sarpa Vishaya, it is an Adhishthana. Thereby you can say that Adhishthana Jnana is Rajya Jnana is Adhishthana Chaitanya Jnana. However, the Adhishthana is different in the case of Sarpajnana. You have said that Sarpajnanasya Adhishthanam Kim. Iti Ukte, you said it is Sakshi Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya Avachinna. Sakshi Chaitanya Avachinna Avidyagata. Avidya Parinama. Avidyagata Sattva. Sattvamsha Parinama, you had said. That is the Sarpajnana. So Sarpajnana was Avidya Parinama, Sattvamsha Parinama, which is Sakshi Chaitanya Nishtha. Now, Sakshi Chaitanya being the Adhishthana, Rajyochinna Chaitanya Jnanena. Once Rajya Jnana takes place and Rajya Vachinna Chaitanya Swayameva Prakashate, then Tajnyanena Sarpajnanam na Nivartate. Sarpajnana will not go because Sarpajnana has a different Adhishthana. So Rajya Jnanena Sarpajnanam na Nivartate iti Akshepa. Nanu Ukta Prakarana Rajya Jnanena Sarpe Nivrutte Sati Api. Even if this Sarpa goes away, which is a Vishaya, due to Rajya Jnana, why? Because Rajya Jnana, although it is not the Adhishthana, directly, Rajyujnana in Siddhanta is Rajyavachina Chaitanya itself. Therefore, it is Adhishthana Jnana. Adhishthana Jnana is Sarpa, which is Adhyaropita, that will go away. Even if it is so. Even if it is so, Sarpa Vishayaka Jnanam Naiva Nivartita. Sarpa Vishaya Jnana will not go away. So, one will still see Sarpa. In the Buddhi, there will be Sarpa. Sarpasya Adhishthanam Rajyavachina Chaitanyam. Sarpajnanasya adhishthanam tu sakshi chaitanyam iti bheda. This is siddhanta bheda, krita bheda. This is what you have said, says the Purvapakshi. You have said that adhishthanas are different for sarpa and sarpajnana. Sarpa vishaya and sarpa vishayaka jnana. Thereby, one adhishthana jnana will not take away other adhishthana gata avidya parinama jnana. Which is Jnana Rupa. It will not take away. Uktaritya tu Rajju Sakshatkarana Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya Prakasheta. So if Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya itself shines forth when Rajju Jnana takes away Rajju Ajnana, then Sarpa Vishaya goes away. Because Rajju Avachinna Chaitanyam Eva Prakasheta, nothing else. Not the rest of the Chaitanya. Not the Ghatapatadi Vishaya Avachinna Chaitanya, however, only Rajya Avachinna Chaitanya. Then Sakshi Chaitanya Bhauduram. Sakshi Chaitanyam na Prakasheta, which is the Adhishthana for Sarpajnana. Ataha Rajyujnane Utpanyapi. Even if Rajyujnana takes place, which is Rajya Avachinna Chaitanya Prakashanam, Sarpajnana Adhishthana Sakshi Chaitanyam Naiva Jnayate. You do not know the Adhishthana, which is for the Sarpajnana, being Sakshi Chaitanya. Then Ajnate cha Adhishthane tadaropita nivruttir nadrashta. Neither do you claim it. Neither it is seen elsewhere that Adhishthana not being known, aropita brahmanivrutti takes place, nor do you claim it. So in your Siddhanta itself, it is not possible. Laukika Pramana is not there, so I don't have to agree. Thereby, Purvapakshi says, Kintu jnate eva adhishthane tadaropita adhishthana aropita nivruttir bhavet. So adhishthana sakshi chaitanya should be known for sarpajnana to go away, otherwise sarpajnana will stay away. So your anyata khyati also has flaw. What is the flaw? The Rajju Vishaya, Rajju avachinna chaitanya being known due to rajju jnana, sarpa vishaya will go away. Sarpa will go away outside, but then inside you will have sarpa jnana. This is as bad as your asat khyati, akhyati vada. In akhyati vada also your argument was rajju is outside, which is a vishaya. Now there is no longer a sarpa, anirochani sarpa is no longer there because rajju jnana has taken away sarpa as a vishaya, which was avidya parinama. That has gone. So outside what is there? It has to be Rajju. There is no Sarpa anymore. Anirvachaniya Sarpa is also not there. Rajju is there. Then how can you have Vishaya and Jnana Bheda? This was your argument to the Sankhyas and Prabhakaras. You are falling into the same category after the Rajju Jnana takes place because Sarpa Jnana Vritti will continue to be there. Tasmat Rajju Jnanena Sarpa Jnana Sinivritti Nauva Padyate Iti Chet. If this is the Aropa done, what do you have to say? There the Siddhanti says, Sarpa Bhava Sarpa Jnanasya Karane Laya Rupa Nivrittir Iti Samadhihi. This is one way of explaining. Whichever you understand, you can hold on to that. The other methodology is complex, but then he is coming more and more towards Siddhanta. There are two ways it is explained. One way, the Sarpa being outside. What is the Sarpa Vishaya Adhishthana and what is the Sarpa Jnana Adhishthana? There has been a Bheda. This Bheda is notional because Chaitanya is one. The Bheda itself is notional. However, there is another way to explain. Whereas the Adhishthana for everything will be one, which is the real Siddhanta. We have not come to yet that part yet. However, just a heads up that the Chaitanya Abheda will also come up as Adhishthana. Because there may be the possible flaw in this. Possible as per the Purva Pakshi. And we say, okay, let me give you another solution in that case. We accommodate the such, you know, those who are not able to understand the possibility of such a thing happening, we give another option also. If the Purva Pakshi is a Siddhanti really, meaning it is a student who is asking, then he may pick either of them which is appropriate to him. He is Buddhi, which helps him to understand and land on the Siddhanta, hold on to the Aikya Tattva. That is the goal finally. As long as it leads there, any prakriya is okay. So we will give multiple answers. That's why even in the Uttamadhikari section, we are looking at multiple options. Then there will be for Madhyama Adhikari and Adhama Adhikari, there will be more prakriyas talked about. So here what has been said, outside there is a different Chaitanya, so to say. Inside there is a different Chaitanya, so to say. Because all these are eva. Bheda eva bheda. There is no real bheda. This much we have to anyway remember. I assume that everyone knows that Chaitanya bheda is eva. Bheda eva bheda. Now, Sarpa Bhava, if there is no Sarpa outside, why did Sarpa Jnana take place? Sarpa Jnana took place because there is Sarpa Vishaya outside. Anirvachaniya Sarpa Vishaya, which was a transformation of Avidya. Thereby, Sarpa Jnana took place, which is also a transformation of Avidya within. Simultaneously, however, there is a Nimitta. You cannot have a Sarpa Jnana without a Sarpa, Anirvachaniya Sarpa being outside. That is why Yugapat Jayate. If the Sarpa Vishaya and Sarpa Jnana have come together, what is the Karana for that? Of course, Rajju Ajnana is the Karana. Rajju Ajnana is the Karana for the Anirvachaniya Sarpa Vishaya to come outside, as well as the Rajju Jnana to come up inside. So, Nimittapaye, Naimittikasya Apaya, this is a Vyakrana rule also. Only if there is a Nimitta, there will be Naimittika. Nimittika being a Taddhisa, it is Nimitta Sambandhi. Nimitta is not there. How can you have Naimittika, which is Nimitta Sambandhi, will not linger on? When Karana itself is not there, which is Rajju Ajnana, which has gone away by Rajju Jnana, how can there be Karya? The Karya which was Sarpa Vishaya, but not only Sarpa Vishaya, that goes away. Sarpa Jnana is also Karya. So that will also go away. So this is a simplified version of what actually happens. He says, Atra Uchyate. Vishyadhinam. Sarpa bhava, sarpa jnana bhava. Because sarpa is no longer there, which was anirvachaniya sarpa outside. Now that anirvachaniya sarpa is also not there. Why? Because rajju jnana took away the rajju ajnana, which was the karana outside to create an anirvachaniya sarpa. So vishyadhinam hi jnanam bhavati. Vishaya, the my jnana sarpajnana within is dependent on the vishaya outside. That vishaya going, I don't have anything else. So rajju ajnana being the cause, the one way to explain is rajju ajnana was the cause. Rajju ajnana went away. I don't have any avidya transformation anymore outside or inside. As a vishaya or as jnana, sarpa vishaya or sarpajnana. Then if you look into more details, sarpa bhava, sarpajnana bhava. Vishyadhinam hi jnanam bhavati. There is no vishaya. How can you have vishaya jnana? In fact, we are in line with what argument which we put across. We are in line with the argument we put across to refute the akhyativadi sankhyamata or prabhakaramata of disconnect between the vishaya and the jnana. We don't have a disconnect. In fact, we are saying that there is no disconnect. Whatever is the vishaya, that is the jnana. So vishaya is anirvachaniya sarpa, that goes away. So sarpa bhava, sarpa jnana bhava. Jnana will also go away, sarpa jnana. In fact, you should not put an aropa. You should say that this is what should happen in your case. We agree, that's what happens. Vishyadhinam hi jnanam bhavati rajju sakshatkarena uktaritya. The way it has been explained elaborately, rajju achinna chaitanya aropita sarparupa vishaya nivrutya sarpa jnanam api sva vishaya bhavat nivartata eva. Because the sarpa which went away due to sarpa jnana going away due to sarpa jnana, therefore sarpajnana utpatti having taken away the sarpajnana and the rajjujnana which has taken away the rajjujnana and thereby countering the vikshepa also, avarana goes away, vikshepa also goes away which was in the form of rajju vishaya. Therefore rajjochinna chaitanya aropita sarparupa vishaya. The sarparupa vishaya was a vikshepa. Because there was Rajya Vachinna Chaitanya Avarana. So Rajya Sakshatkarena Uktaritya. Uktaritya means what? Rajya Jnana takes place, which is Rajya Vachinna Chaitanya Prakashana. That being the Adhishthana, it takes away the Aropita Sarpa Vishaya. So Aropita Rupa Sarpa Vishaya Nivrutya, when that Nivrutti takes place, Sarpa Jnanam Api Svavishaya Bhavat Nivartata Eva. So vishaya bhava, because jnana needs vishaya. So is sarpa jnanam is sarpa jnana vishaya. What is sarpa jnana vishaya? Sarpa. Sarpa jnana, so is sarpa jnanam. Sarpa jnanam api sarpa jnana vishaya bhava. For sarpa jnana, there has to be vishaya, which has to be sarpa. Basically, what sarpa bhava nivartate eva, which is the vishaya for sarpa jnanam. Vishaya not being there, vishayadhinam hi jnanam bhavati. Vishaya not being there, vishaya bhavat jnana bhavah. Sarpa vishaya bhavat, anirvachaniya sarpa vishaya bhavat, anirvachaniya sarpa jnana bhavah, meaning sarpa jnana nivrutti, brahma nivrutti bhavet. This is the siddhanta. Siddhanti answers this to this. Sakshi jnanam antara sarpa jnanam na nivarteta iti akshepa. No, that wouldn't be possible, says the Purvapakshi. Why? Sakshi jnanam antara. You cannot switch sides now. You cannot switch prakriyas. You have said that there is sarpa jnana vritti taking place, which is karya of avidya within. That avidya is sakshi nishtha, sakshi chaitanya nishtha avidya. Therefore, sakshi jnana is needed, because avidya should go wherever there is the adhishtana, there alone the avidya should go away. How will avidya or ajnana, which is within, go away by something changing outside? because you have said that there is transformation of avidya within. You did not say that because there is Vishaya outside, which is Sarpa, therefore there is Sarpa Jnana. Otherwise, I'll ask you, if there is Sarpa, then you explain the Vritti going out, transforming into Sarpa, which is what you explain in the case of Rajju. But you have not taken to that path when explaining Sarpa Jnana taking place. Sarpa Jnana did not come up this way. You conveniently said that it is not Antakarana Vritti, it is Avidya Vritti. Now your avidya vritti, you have to explain how will that go away, because there are two different avidyas. There are two different avidya transformations. They are in different deshas also. They have different chaitanya as their substratum, as their adhishthana. One adhishthana is known, the other adhishthana is not known. How will sarpa jnana go away? Do not give me an explanation that Sarpa Vishaya is not there anymore, because Sarpa Vishaya was not the cause at all. The cause was avidya transformation, and it was simultaneous, all right. But simultaneously, avidya transformation took place. Now that transformation to cease, your explanation is Adhishthana Jnana. Adhishthana Jnana took place outside. What about Adhishthana inside, sir? Sakshi Chaitanya is not known. How will that avidya go away? That avidya won't go away. If it does not go away, what will happen? The sarpa has to remain in jnana. Sarpa jnana remains. You cannot argue another way to as a solution. Therefore, please explain in your own methodology, the way the sarpa came up, the nivritti also should take place in the same way. Don't shift prakriyas. This is the Purvapakshi knows how the Siddhanti's way and way out also. He says, this is not right. Sakshi Jnana Mantara. Sakshi Jnana should show me where is the Sakshi Jnana. Adhishthana Jnanam Mantara. Without Adhishthana Jnana, which happens to be Sakshi Jnana, Sakshi Chaitanya, without knowing that Sakshi, the Avidya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya Nishtha, will not go away. Therefore, Avidya Karya, which is Vikshepa, will not go away. So Avarana Bhanga does not take place. Vikshepa will continue to be there and it will appear to be real. Sarpajnanam nanivarteta iti akshepa. Sarpajnana won't go away. Nanu katham adhishthana jnanamantara tadaropita bhramo nivarteta. How can the aropita bhrama go away without adhishthana being known? The same question that I had asked you outside, it remains with respect to jnana inside. So Vishaya is gone. I agree. I have absolutely no issues. Vishaya is gone. Sarpa Vishaya is gone. But Sarpa Jnana will not go. Sarpa Jnanam api kalpitam. Sarpa Jnana is Bhranti, Brahmaha. Therefore it is kalpita. Tasya hi adhishthanam Sakshi Chaitanya. It is Sakshi Chaitanya Nishtha Avidya Parinama. Therefore it is Sattva Amsha, all right. Amsha I don't care about, because Amsha is Pradhanyam. It is what is the main content in avidya, but avidya is there in both places, inside and outside. Adhishthanam antara, adhishthana jnanam antara, aropita brahma na nivarteta. So Sakshi Chaitanyam being the adhishthana, Sakshi Chaitanya has to be known. Outside you said Rajju Jnana will make the Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya known, because it will shine forth, that itself Jnana is Chaitanya. But Jnana has Veda here. Jnana outside and that Rajju Jnana outside, Rajju outside, Rajju Jnana, Rajju Nishtha Chaitanya is Rajju Jnana. Then what about the Sarpa Jnana inside? Tajnana Mantara, Tatra Kalpita Sarpa Jnanam Nanivarteta Iti Chet. Tajnana Mantara means Sakshi Chaitanya Jnana Mantara, Tatra Kalpita Sarpa Jnanam Nanivarteta Iti Chet. Tatra Eva, Tasmin Eva, Sakshi Chaitanya, Tasminneva, Tatra is Tasminneva Sakshi Chaitanya Kalpita Sarpajnana. Where is Sarpajnana? It is not outside, it is within. Therefore, it will not go away without Sakshi Chaitanya being known. If that is the Aropa, what do you have to say? Sakshi Jnana Mantara Api Sarpajnana Nivartyate Iti Samadharam. No, it is possible. I'll explain how. Without the Sakshi Jnana, also Sarpajnana can go away. How so? Atrapi Uchyate. The answer is given so. Nivritti Dvividha. There are two types of Nivritti. you are holding on to one type of nivritti. I am going to show you another type of nivritti which is possible even without the sakshi jnana. So there are two types of nivrittis. So Siddhanti has brought in what is the nivritti itself here. Nivritti does not mean the same thing as what it means for the Purva Pakshi when the Siddhanti is saying. Siddhanti means a different type of nivritti. What is that? Nivritti Dvidha. There are two types of nivrittis. One is Atyantika Nivritti, complete cessation. Karanatmana Avasthiti Rupa Nivrittischa Iti. The other is Karanatmana Avasthitihi. The Karya resolving into the Karana. That is a different kind of Nivritti. That is the Nivritti I mean, says the Siddhanti. So Karya resolving into Karana does not need Adhishthana Jnana. How so? Give me an example. So that section comes up now. Atyantika Nivritti is one type of Nivritti. You are expecting that. Other is Karanatmana Avasthiti Rupa Nivritti. In the form of resolution into the Karana. So Karya resolves as Karana. These are the two types of Nivrittis. Anyway, let's look at the example given by the Tippanakara. So it will drive home easily when we read further. Patasya sopadana bhuta tantubhissadahah atyantika nivrittihi. Gatasya dhvamse murudbhavapatto layarupa nivritti. So there is atyantika nivritti and layarupa nivritti. There are two types of nivrittis. Patasya sopadana bhuta tantubhissadahah. Daha burning. What burns? Sopadana bhuta tantubhi saha daha patasya. The cloth being burnt along with its upadana karana, material cause, which is a thread. The cloth is burnt, and when the cloth is burnt, what is really burnt? All the threads have to be burnt. Then only we say that the cloth is gone. Along with its cause, it is gone. Atyantika nivritti. There is nothing. There is nothing called cloth there. There is nothing called thread there. Everything is burnt. That is atyantika dahaha in the case of dahana, which is atyantika nivritti. Kasya patasya atyantika nivritti. Because it has gone completely. It has gone away. You don't see the threads also. Not that the pata is not there, but the threads are there. That's not the case. Completely being burnt, there is no karana, rupa, tantu also, threads also do not exist. That is atyantika nivritti. However, in the case of ghata, when the ghatasya dhvamse mrudbhava pattu, when the ghata is broken and it says churani karoti, somebody breaks it and starts, beating it up with a hammer or whatever, grinds it to a powder. Just like this dahana is burning, but here in ghata can be, ground to the ground. So if it is completely ground up, what will happen after grinding dhamse? Ghata dhamse has taken place. What has happened though? Murudbhava pattu. Ghata is in the form of mrut now. The karana for ghata was mrut. Ghata was karya. Then karya dhamse, what has happened? Karana bhava pattu. Satyam. When there is mrutbhava for the ghata, karana bhava, then that is layarupa nivritti. We say ghata has resolved into its cause, which is clay. So with that example, with those two examples, it should be easy to see what comes up here. Swakaranena saha eva karyasya nivritti atyantiki nivritti ityuchyate. Example we have seen, patadaha, patadahanam. Swakaranena sa, karana is also burnt, tantu is burnt along with the pata, karyasya nivruttihi, it is atyantiki nivruttihi. Iti uchyate. However, kalpita vastu cannot have such kind of dahana. Example was not of kalpita vastu, ghata, example ghata becoming mrut. However, ghata nama rupa is also kalpita in mrut. Let that be aside. That is the exemplified. In the example, kalpita vastunam rajus sarpas thale, कल्पित वस्तुनाम सर्वेषां कारणं तु तद अधिष्ठान चैतन्याश्रित तदावारक तद आवा तद आवारक आवरण इट शुड बी आवरक आई थिंक तदावरक तद आवरक अज्ञानम एव आवारक आवरक आई थिंक दैट्स टाइपो देयर कल्पित वस्तुनाम सर्वेषां सो सर्वेषां कल्पित वस्तुनाम सर्प रजतादीनाम सर्वेषां कारणं तु तद अधिष्ठान चैतन्याश्रित तदावरक तद अधिष्ठान इज इन द केस ऑफ रज्जु सर्प लेट्स से सर्प अधिष्ठान चैतन्य व्हाट इज द अधिष्ठान चैतन्य रज्जवच्छिन्न चैतन्य सो तद अधिष्ठान चैतन्य इज रज्जवच्छिन्न चैतन्य विच इज सर्प अधिष्ठान रज्जवच्छिन्न चैतन्य आश्रित There is avidya which is, has taken ashraya there, ajnana. That ajnana is in chaitanya. Which chaitanya? It is adhishthana chaitanya. Rajyavachinna chaitanya ashrita ajnana. And what is that ajnana? It does avarana. Avarana of what? Avarana of that very chaitanya. Rajyavachinna chaitanya avarana. Therefore, Rajju is not known. Rajju is not known. Rajju visheshamsha is not known because Rajyavachinna chaitanya does not shine forth. There is an avarana on it. Therefore, tadadishthana chaitanya, meaning kalpita vastu being sarpa, rajju sarpa, kalpita vastu rajju sarpa, sarpasya karanam tu, karana is sarpa, rajju sarpa adishthana, which is rajju अवच्छिन्न चैतन्य आश्रित तदावरक इज रज्जु आवरक और रज्जु अवच्छिन्न चैतन्य आवरक रियली रज्जु आवरक मीन्स रज्जु अवच्छिन्न चैतन्य आवरक अज्ञानम एव इट इज अज्ञान तस्माद् अधिष्ठान चैत्यान चैतन्यारोप तस्माद् अधिष्ठान चैतन्य अपरोक्ष ज्ञानीन एव अज्ञानं तत्कार्यं च सर्वं आरोपितं निशेषं निवर्तते सो व्हेन विल द आरोपित गो अवे व्हेन द अधिष्ठान इज नोन सो तस्माद् अधिष्ठान चैतन्य अपरोक्ष ज्ञानीन इट शुड बिकम अपरोक्ष डायरेक्टली नोन नॉट थ्रू तर्क यू शुड लैंड ऑन Finally, that tarka should lead to aparoksha siddhi. Aparoksha jnana should take place that I know there is a rajju. That is aparoksha jnana. So when tasmad adhishthana chaitanya aparoksha jnanina eva ajnanam tatkaryancha. Ajnana goes away, which is rajju ajnana, rajju vachina chaitanya. There is a ajnana about that. So rajju ajnana is gone now and therefore tatkarya also, tatkaryam cha. सर्वं आरोपितं निशेषं निवर्तते दे एवरीथिंग दैट इज अ रिजल्टेंट एज अध्यास ऑल दैट विल गो अवे कार्यस्य कारणे लय रूप निवृत्तिस्तु कार्यस्य कारणे लय रूप निवृत्तिस्तु विनापि अधिष्ठान ज्ञानं जायेत बट विदाउट नोइंग द कारण आल्सो कार्य कैन हैव रिजोल्यूशन इन द कारण विना अपि अधिष्ठान ज्ञानम् हाउ सो गिव मी एन एग्जांपल इज सुषुप्तौ प्रलये च टेक दी सुषुप्ति एग्जांपल और प्रलय एग्जांपल व्हाट हैपेंस देयर डू यू नो दी कारण यू डोंट नो दी कारण फॉर दी कार्य देयर इज अ कारण शरीर एंड सूक्ष्म शरीर एंड स्थूल शरीर आर कार्यास दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड कारण शरीर शरीरद्वयस्य कारणं कारणशरीरं विचारति शरीरद्वय सूक्ष्मशरीर एंड स्थूलशरीर कारणशरीर इज द कारण फॉर बोथ डू यू नो द कारणशरीर और द कारणशरीर इज एक्चुअली अज्ञान विच इज साक्षीनिष्ठ अगेन डू यू नो दैट चैतन्य एट ऑल अधिष्ठान चैतन्य डू डू नॉट नो कारण शरीर निवृत्ति डज नॉट टेक प्लेस अज्ञान निवृत्ति बट स्टिल यू गो डू गो टू स्लीप वेर देर इज नीदर ड्रीम नॉर देर इज अ ड्रीमर नीदर इज देर the waker nor the waking world. So the waking world as well as the dream world is a projection out of the Karana Sharira, which is Ajnana Rupa. So Vidya itself is called as Karana Sharira. So what happens there? Shushuptau Pralaye Cha. In Pralaya, Maya is the resolution ground. Shushuptau Pralaye Cha Sakala Padarthanam Vinayava Adhishthana Jnanam Ajnane Swakarane Layo Bhavati. In their own Karana, which is Ajnana, for Sakala Padarthas, all Padarthas, in Shushupti, the entire Prapancha, Jagrit Prapancha, as well as the Swapna Prapancha, has Laya in its own Karana, which is Ajnana, Karana Sharira, Swakarane Layo Bhavati. In Pralaya, Maya is the Adhishthana, at the universal level. Shushupti is Nitya Pralaya. And what is Pralaya? Pralaya is Dirga Sushupti for each and every Jiva. So both are interchangeable words. One is at the individual level, another is at the total level. If you do not make a bheda of universal and total, there is no problem at all. Avidya is equal to Maya, Sushupti equal to Pralaya, no difference at all. But if there is a difficulty, you hold on to bheda and continue with universal and individual level. Sakala Padarthanam Vinayava Adhishthana Jnanam Ajnane Svakarane Layo Bhavati. You do not care about Maya. There are people who do not know what is Maya. They don't know the spelling of Maya. They have never heard the word Maya. But do they go to sleep or not? They don't know anything about Chaitanya, Ishvara, Maya, Jiva. Nothing is known. But still, Avidya, Ityadi, they still go to sleep. They will also be resolved into, during Pralaya, they will also be resolved into Maya. Along with the entire Prapancha. Their own as well as subjective and objective, prapancha, all that will be resolved, is resolved. Swakarani layo bhavati, adhishthana jnanam vina, tada sarvadrishya padartha laya hetuhu, tattad bhoga pradak karma uparamaha eva. What is the karana for that? Explaining in another way so that the Purvapakshi understands, or the Siddhanti was raised a question, either way, so that the point is driven home. What is the point? Sarpa sarpa vishaya bhavat sarpa jnanam api nivarteta. Sarpa vishaya has gone, sarpa jnana can also go away. No, it cannot go away. Why? Why adhishtana should be known? There is no rule that the way it came up, the same way it should be resolved. There is absolutely no rule. I mean, all this is a mithya pramancha. Maya sarvasya sambhavat. What is possible in anirvachane khyati, the way it goes away is also anirvachaniya. It need not be in sync with the way we have explained. We are talking about possibilities. Do you give in to the possibility first? Then the possibility grows upon you. Then the other ideas that you had, oh, this is how it should be. It should be, you know, exactly methodologically, you know, point-wise explained. It should never change. You know, 100 on 100 marks. This is not an exam. You have given into the possibility, that possibility has grown upon you. Now the Purva Paksha should seem impossible. That is Ajnana Nivritti in reality. The possibility should grow upon you so much. Oh, there is an example. It can be this way. If it can be this way, why not? Each and every Purva Paksha question should be, why not? Answer should be, why not? Why not? Is it possible? In one case, then why not here? No, it should be this way. Why? So for his why nots, we have to have why. For his why, we have to have why nots. Not as Vitanda. This should be very clear to us as to there is a possibility. We have examples. And if they are convincing, why not here? Why should it be in the same way? If a potter made a pot in with clay, does he, you know, by, you know, heating it up, does he pour water? I mean, for to destroy the pot, do you have to pour water? Because it came up with heat, it should go only with cooling it down. Does it happen so? He added water, he moved it on the chakra. Do you move it the other way around and say, no, I wanted the resolution the same way. I want the ghata to go back to clay. Will it go back if you move it in the reverse manner? It will not go away. You cannot take away heat by pouring water and say, okay, I want it to melt down. It is possible that you may be able to melt down every part of the clay, every part of every clay part of the pot by pouring water through and through, and it may melt down someday, God knows. That may be possible, but we ask, is it possible that I just take a hammer or drop the pot and it just gets destructed? It's possible. Why do you insist that it should be only the same way that it came up? There is no reason, absolutely no reason. Thereby, Shushuptau Pralayacha Sakala Padarthana Vinayava Adhishthana Jnana Vajnane Svakarane Layo Bhavati Tada Sarvadrishya Padartha Laya Hetuhu. What is the Laya Hetuhu there? Tattat Bhoga Prada Karma Uparamaha Eva. Karmanaha or Karmanam Uparamaha. Cessation of karma. Which karma? The karma which is Bhoga Prada. Bhogam Bhogani. No, Bhoga would be pulling a Bhoga, Ghayanta perhaps. So, Bhogan Prakarshena Dadati iti Bhoga Prada. What is that Bhoga Pradam? Here, karma, neuter. Therefore, Bhogan Prakarshena Dadati iti Bhoga Prada Karma. That karma seizing. Or karmani, in plural we'll take it as karmani. Bhogan pradadati, instead of pradadati, prakarshena dadati, in plural. Iti bhoga pradani karmani. Why was he in waking and dream? Why is any jiva in waking and dream? Because prarabdha is due. Prarabdha bhoga is due. There is karma. He has done karma, so there will be bhoga. It is forced upon the karta. One claimed to be a karta, he cannot avoid being bhokta. So bhoktruttvam is forced upon by the law of karma. No, I don't want anything, so he prefers to sleep through the day. No, I don't want to step out. The entire world is out to get me. Okay, you sleep. Can you sleep? No, sometimes you cannot sleep. Why? Because karma is due. It will force you to act. Bhagavan Krishna tells Arjuna, no matter you try to avoid, but still it will force you. Svabhavastu pravartate. Svabhava will continue. You will be forced out of bed. You will jump and act because whatever you like will come up, or whatever you dislike, you will have to resolve, get out of the bed. You cannot sleep. It will torture. Okay, I'll take a sleeping pill and sleep. Okay. One may take a sleeping pill, but still the dream will force you out. That is the prarabdha bhoga. Unless the prarabdha is over for that moment in waking and dream, one cannot go to deep sleep. And when the prarabdha is over, one cannot force oneself by, you know, whatever. What do they have these days? I think kids have Red Bull. I need more caffeine. So drink coffee after coffee, Red Bull, whatever, gulp it down and stay awake. Still one cannot stay away because prarabdha is not due for fructification. Want to watch a movie, want to play, party out, but the sleep overwhelms because there is bhoga prada karma, which is over. Uparamaha. Once that bhoga prada karma is over, then what will happen? That will become the hetu for laya of sarvadrishya padarthaha. All the padarthas will get resolved into their karana. Svakarane layo bhavati. Evam eva antara api adhishthana sakshi jnanam sarpa jnanam nivartate. What effort do you take? What knowledge do you need to have to sleep? Nothing. You fall asleep. No knowledge is needed. In fact, no knowledge can help you to stay awake. That waking is different. To stay awake to your own reality, you can go to deep sleep also, but you will still be awake to your reality. Because it will pop up when you wake up. The jnani wakes up as a jnani, ajnani wakes up as a ajnani. No jnana is going to help you to not fall asleep. Because karma bhoga keeps you awake in waking or in dream. Once that ceases, that is the karana. Hetu for sarvadrishya padartha laya. Here the same thing is happening. Sarpa jnana laya bhavati. Why? Because swakarana laya, swakarana uparamaha, which is sarpa vishaya uparamaha. Sarpa vishaya uparamaha. becomes the hetu for the sarpajnana laya. Evam eva antarapi adhisthana sakshi jnanam sarpajnanam nivartate. So you don't need to know the sakshi jnana chaitanya, sakshi chaitanya. Without that also there can be sarpajnana nivritti. Tatra sarpajnana vishayibhuta sarpabhava eva sarpajnana nivrittehe karanam bhavati. Tatra, in that case, what is happening? Sarpajnana vishayibhuta sarpasya abhavaha. Sarpa vishaya, which was there outside, its abhava has taken place. Now this abhava was not a vishaya. So here vishayi, here is, it is not a ini pratyanta. Vishayasya sthiti vishayi na. What is it then? It is chvi pratyanta. Abhuta tadbhave chvi. Chvi pratyaya is ordained for what wasn't there, but now is there. With, I think, krubhasti yoga, there will be krubhu or asdhatu used there. With, so, with vishayi is an avyaya. Some say that it is a compound with bhuta. Here it is bhuta, but then sometimes you see a, you know, bhavati or, you know, vishayi bhavati, vishayi kriyate. In all those cases, with the krudan, the vishayi, which is a taddhita, you cannot have, which is a subanta, you cannot have a samasa with a tinganta. Kriyate, bhavati, will be tinganta. Some do say that there is a possibility of a samasa, there is a matabheda, but then vishayi is an avyaya. What is the meaning? Vishayi bhuta has the meaning of yanna vishayam. Na vishayaha. What is not a vishaya? Yaha na vishayaha sa vishaya bhutaha. So what is not vishaya has become a vishaya. What is that? Sarpa bhava. Sarpa bhava was not a vishaya earlier. What was the vishaya? Sarpa was the vishaya. So vishayi is vishayi bhuta sarpa bhava. They are in karmadharaya. Vishayi bhutaha yaha sarpa bhavaha. Sarpa bhavaha yaha prayaha na vishayaha. Vishaya na saha vishayaha bhutaha. Adya iti vishayi bhutaha sarpa bhava. Sarpa bhava has become a vishaya for the sakshi now. Therefore, sarpajnana, sarpajnana vishayi bhuta sarpa bhava eva. Sarpajnana nivritte karanam bhavati. What will happen? For sarpajnana nivritti, what will be the karana? The sarpa bhava, which has become a vishaya now. Sarpa bhava will become a vishaya, then sarpajnana vishayi bhuta sarpa bhava eva sarpajnana nivritte karanam bhavati. Ithanja rajyujnanena sarpo nivartate. Anyway, forget about the chvi. In this case, what is happening? Sarpajnana vishayi bhuta sarpa bhavaha eva sarpajnana nivritte karanam bhavati vinapi adhisthana jnanam. There is no adhisthana jnana expected there. There is a possibility, as we saw in the example, in the exemplified, that's what is happening. No longer is the sarpa a vishaya, sarpa bhava is a vishaya, and thereby sarpa jnana nivritte karanam bhavati. Or rather, what has happened? Hetu going away. We can look at it in the same way as the example. Example is the hetu has gone away. That was a technical explanation. Need not be a real vishaya. That's a chi usage I explained. Need not, sarpa bhava need not become vishaya also. Sarpa was a vishaya, that vishaya went away. Therefore, jnana also went away. Tajnana. Sarpa jnana nivrte karana bhavati itthancha rajyu jnana sarpo nivartate tatascha sarpa jnana vishayi bhuta sarpa bhava eva sarpa jnana se laya rupa nivruttam nimittam bhavati. So he is also explained with a chvi kind of a meaning. Sarpa bhava itself will become a hetu for nimitta, for sarpa jnana laya. Laya rupa nivritti. It is not atyanta, atyantiki nivritti. It is laya rupa nivritti. Sarpa, where did the sarpa jnana go? Sarpa jnana went away into its karana, which is the avidya, which is sakshi jnana nishtha. Sakshi jnana gata. Sarpa jnana karana is avidya. There itself the sarpa jnana got resolved. For that, no Adhisthana Jnana is expected. Thereby, what has happened is, without the Sakshi Jnana also, Sakshi Chaitanya Jnana also, what has happened? Adhisthana Jnana also, without Adhisthana Jnana, there can be Sarpa Jnana Nivruti. Rajju Jnana Samaye Sarpa Jnana Adhisthana Bhuta Sakshi Bhanam Api Sambhavati Iti Samadhanam. Athava, now this is another Paksha, we look at this Paksha in the next part. One Paksha is closed. One possibility of how this Sarpa Vishaya Nivritti takes place and Sarpa Jnana Nivritti takes place. How is the Sarpa Jnana in the first Paksha that we close now? Sarpa Vishaya goes away by Rajju Jnana. Why? Because Rajju Jnana is Adhisthana Jnana. Adhisthana Rajyavachinna Chaitanyam Prakashate Swayameva Prakashate by Rajju Jnana, which is Rajju Vritti. Due to that, Rajju Jnana takes place, which is going to counter the Rajju Jnana and the Adhisthana, Rajyavachinna Chaitanya is known. Swayam Prakashate, thereby what will happen? Adhisthana Jnanena Adhyasa Nivritti, Aropita Nivritti, Aropita Sarpa Vishaya Nivritti. That goes away. Then what happens? Sarpa Vishaya Abhavat, Sarpa Jnana Nivritti within. Sarpa Jnana goes away because Sarpa Vishaya is no longer there. Sarpa Vishaya Abhavat, Padartha Abhava has taken place, thereby Nimitta is no longer there, which was actually Rajju Ajnana. But it was explained in various ways as to Sarpa Jnana can go away even without the Sakshi Chaitanya, which is the Adhisthana for Sarpa Jnana, being known. Without its being known also, it can go away with the example of Laya in Sushupti. We saw it is not Atyantiki Nivritti, it is Laya Rupa Nivrittihi. So that is the example we saw, and the exemplified is explained using the Laya Rupa Nivritti. Nimittam Bhavati Sarpa Jnanasya. What is that? Nimitta Sarpa Bhavaha. The Athava part, how in another manner it can take place, we'll see in the next part. Sukan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Nama Rupayo Adhisthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Rukyatma Nirvan Aparam Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Hanamatyon Nirviti Menishchita Matihi. Any questions? Okay, no questions. Namaste. See you in the next part.